Hey guys, I am Josh and welcome to my channel Video Epo. Here on my table is a tub of water on which there's a small boat floating on it, which is powered by a small candle. Come have a closer look. This, my friends, is called a put-put boat or a pop-up boat. I'm going to shut up for a while and let you listen to the sound it makes. My father bought me one of these put-put boats when I was about the age of 4. It was total fun, let me tell you. It was equivalent to the modern toy drones that you get. That's because those days the toys were coil wound, so it would run for a while and it would stop. On the other hand, a toy boat like this would run for a lot more time compared to the mechanical coil wound toys. However, the coil wound toys have not gone entirely out of fashion. Have a look at this one. This is better than Batman's Batmobile tumbler. Getting back into the subject, in this video I'm going to make pop-up boats, a few of them actually. I'll try and explain the science behind it, clear some obvious doubts, and see which one of my builds performs better. As for my channel, I try a lot of different things. You can have a quick look and we'll dive into the video right after. Some of my friends were asking me to make videos that are simple and easy to make, something that doesn't need a lot of tools like these. Now, I do make such videos, but I post it in a different channel and the links of which are given in the description below. Now, I posted a video which is called How to Make a Candle Powered Put-Put Boat, and that video has got more than 16 lakh views. And it also has got a lot of questions to be answered, and I thought I should answer those questions here. Forgive my shameless self-advertising here. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is to open up this boat and show you how the engine looks like. Don't be disappointed, guys. Sometimes simplicity is best, and this is a very simple steam engine. Now, this part is the reservoir. It is airtight and it is welded and it's sealed properly. So before starting the engine, it has to be primed with water. So there is water present already inside this engine. And when you place a candle, the water inside this engine, it starts boiling. When it starts boiling, it becomes steam and it expands. As it expands, it tries to find a way to get out and it goes out through one of these tubes. And when it goes out, so there is Newton's third law of motion. So every action has got an equal and opposite reaction. So the water goes out this way, or the steam goes out this way, and it propels the boat in the forward direction. And when the water is out, there is going to be a low pressure area here and the water will sucked in through the other tube. So you might ask me, so water is getting sucked in and the water is getting pushed out, so the boat has to stay in the same place. Now the physics behind this is a lot complex, and this is what I understand of, is that the force that is going to come out from one of these nozzles is much more than what is going to go inside. So the boat is always in a forward motion. For the first build, we would need an aluminium soda can. I'm not a big fan of carbonated sugar water, but this can works best for this project. You might be tempted to use other tin cans like these. This can is a bit hard and not good to work with, at least without any tools. If you find cans with thin pressure nozzles or flammable stuff, stay away. You don't need them, they are not safe. Two points you might want to note here. It needs to have a big opening like this, and it should be easy to crush it without much effort. To make the engine, we only need one of these cans. It's more than enough. We'll keep the rest away. And we also need a couple of straws. I'm picking the ones that have got the complete bend like this, and you will see why that is important, because when we make the engine, you need that engine to be on top of the fire like this. It won't be on top of the fire, so I'm gonna take these two and discard the rest for now. So let's start making the engine. You got to be really careful, wear gloves if it's necessary, but it is quite easy to cut these things. You've got to be really careful with these serrated edges. Once it is cut, it can hurt you. The goal here is to cut this can into a thin sheet. It has a tendency to roll back, so secure it with some weights while you work. We don't need the entire sheet here. A small piece, approximately 4 inches by 1.5 inches, will be more than enough. Now, I'm going to flip it over and bend it like so, simply because I don't want to see the labels.
Imagine that we are making a tiny envelope with this aluminium sheet with one side open. The seams on all sides are bent over and pressed firmly, but not too hard. These seams are not leak proof yet, but we will tackle that later. The straws are inserted into the open side, leaving the bent portion outside this aluminium envelope you just made.
Now it's time for the glue up.
To cover up the seams, I'm using a two-pot epoxy here, but I don't think it's an ideal choice. I figured that out later. It's better to use any high-temperature gasket sealant or putty brands like M-Seal.
The glue is set and this is completely airtight. I did a quick check by dipping this part into water and blowing air through it. There were no bubbles, no air bubbles, which means it is leak-proof. Another important question a lot of people ask is, if I were to put a burning candle underneath this part, will the straws not melt? As long as there is water in this chamber, it will not melt. Let me make a quick demonstration for that.
I've got a balloon here which is filled with air. I'm going to put a flame underneath it and that's what happens. But now, I've got another balloon here which has got some water. Okay, there's water inside. Now I'm going to put a flame underneath it. It's able to withstand that, right? It's not bursting. See, that's because the heat is getting transferred into the water. It will burst eventually when there is no proper heat transfer, but now, for now, it is holding good, right?
We now know how to make this engine, and this is a really simple design. All it is an airtight chamber with two tubes jetting out, right? So what I've done is I've made another one where I've used metal tubes instead of plastic tubes. So for the third one, what I've done is I've kept the metal tubes and I changed the body into another bigger tube. So why not make this out of a coil? So what I did is here is I've used another copper tube and I wound it into a coil shape. For the fifth one, I simply made this into a bigger design. So where do you get these kind of metal tubes? Old Antenna is where you can get these metal tubes. And for this coil, I think you'll have to buy it from the hardware stores or maybe from online. So we've got five of these different kinds of engines. Now we'll have to make five different bodies and let's see what options we have.
This is a template I've designed myself and you could download it for free from the link I've given below. We can cut this template and paste it onto the colorful part of a Tetra Pak. This will become the inside of the boat, leaving the waterproof side to be in contact with the water.
It doesn't look like a boat now, but it will in just a few minutes.
No more cuts after this point as you can simply fold it to the shape. Secure the folds with tape or even stapler works here. We need to make five more boats, so I'm using the bottom part of these detergent containers as the other options. I made one last boat out of the aluminium sheet from the can. So we have five different boats here and there is one last step we need to complete. Two holes have to be made in the bottom back of the boat and the tubes are poked through them to a length that will be submerged in water at all times. The holes were sealed with epoxy and the boats won't leak now.
This was supposed to be a straightforward project where I make these boats, run them and I show you the results, but then that would be unfair. And that is because each of these boats required individual modifications for them to perform well. So the results are what I've got here. It might be a little different for you guys. So whatever I'm about to say now, take it with a pinch of salt. Let us look at the performance of the boats and examine the results.
When we fill up the boat engine with water and place the candle, the boat goes off balance. I pulled it out of the tub and made some tweaks. After the adjustments, the boat took off and it works. One problem I've noticed here is the epoxy produces a bad odor and fume, which is unbearable. So keep that in mind. This is the second boat and it was well balanced and also a bit faster than the previous one.
So the boat is working, it's moving forward. So it doesn't have a steering mechanism or I think it's called a rudder. So that would usually guide it. So because of that, it's going and knocking on the walls of the tub. And I don't know why it is not turning. The other boat, it's picking up pace.
The third one was a disaster. It started and then it stopped working because the engine started leaking. I tried fixing it, but it was a waste of time. If it has too many joints, the chances of air leak is more, which results in failure. The one with copper coil was the fastest, but it did not make the pop-up sound. It was very smooth. Maybe the compact shape of the plastic bottle helped it. and the one with the bigger winding didn't work as well, as the flame did not cover the entire coil. Here you can see two of the fastest of the lot. I'm running this footage in real time for your own observation and judgment. So if you're going to make your own put-put boat, you know what to expect. If it runs on your first attempt, it's superb, well and good. But if it doesn't, observe it and based on your observation, make some modifications. If it doesn't work again, simply throw it in trash and do it again, because it is not worth spending your time in tweaking the same thing again. And if you don't want to take up the hassle of making put-put boats, you can always buy it from Amazon, the links of which are given in the description below. By the way, I'm not being paid to say this. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment section below. Guys, you can click on the video on top to see another science-based video like this, and the bottom video is what YouTube thinks is good on my channel. You can click on my channel logo to subscribe to my channel, and the link for the second channel is given in the description below. Thank you for watching this video so far, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, bye.